Well, this morning tea, well, is my cup of choice, and for Adam, it is coffee, like so many of you. So this morning we are teaching all you coffee lovers about the flavors of tea.
Joining us to help us learn about this is Yi Cheng Wan, the owner of Zhen Sha, and James Bousson, the head chef at Zhen Sha. Good morning,
Good
guys.
morning. Good
Thank
morning.
you.
So where do we even begin for a coffee drinker like myself?
Well, when it comes to the stereotype about coffee and tea, most of people think about coffee is something that you go through a drive-through, have to get your coffee, otherwise people won't wake up
It's
before they go to
mandatory,
work.
right?
Having a lot of caffeine to wake you up.
Certainly the popular culture over here. However, few people know that tea actually can do the same in a better way. For example, most people grab coffee in the morning because they would like to feel the energizing caffeine jolt. And however, in tea, caffeine work in a little bit different way. It tend to tea in caffeine and tea tend to release the content of caffeine in a lot more stable rate.
Is there less caffeine too in tea?
Definitely. Although it's less, however, it lasts longer. That's a difference that most people don't know.
And so is all this, the teas that you brought here, are these all caffeinated teas?
That is correct.
Okay, so what
That's
do we
correct.
have?
Well, to begin with, for the audience that may not know too much about tea, we have the white tea, which is the tender baby tea bud coming from the tea plant. Very high in antioxidant.
Okay,
It's very
which is good
much.
for you then.
Yes, absolutely.
You want
That's
the
the thing.
antioxidants.
Antioxidant is actually something to fight against the free radical in your body, which is the reason for a lot of illness and also aging process. And we also have green tea. Most of people know green tea is
That's
actually
yours, isn't
very
it?
healthy.
I like all types of tea. I really do. Green tea is good. In the
Green tea.
morning, though, I take breakfast tea.
Definitely. Green tea, one thing that we need to be aware of, do not drink green tea when you have empty stomach because it is high alkaline content. It can make you a little bit nausea if you actually have empty stomach. And then we have oolong tea. Oolong tea is something that's actually between the green and the black. And therefore, oolong tea, when it's a lighter oolong tea, it resembles the flavor of the green. If it's a darker type of oolong tea, it tastes more like the black.
Well, and James was saying that he actually is a coffee drinker,
Yes,
but
diehard.
has been taking oolong tea, and it's helping you lose weight.
Lose weight, maintain energy levels higher. I don't have that afternoon caffeine crash like you do when your coffee falls off, and just feeling generally better.
Was it hard though to wean yourself off of coffee?
I haven't weaned myself.
Well, I mean,
I still have coffee.
in the afternoon.
Yeah, in the afternoon it was because it'd be like 4 o'clock. Oh, time in the afternoon, a cup of coffee. Because, being a chef, we're there 10, 12 hours a day, lunch, dinner, and then
Got the rush.
Other caterings and parties.
So, all right. So we have what, two more?
Right. That's oolong tea, and then we have the black tea. Most of the people here are very familiar with black tea, especially like English breakfast. And then we have the last one called the dark tea. Dark tea is almost like the cognac of the tea. It's actually the aged tea.
Oh, all right.
Right.
Well, let's make some tea and let's get Adam to taste this because we've got probably less than a minute left here.
Okay. What we have here is a black tea. Today we're using Ceylon. We're going to make a chai tea, which comes to us from India. So we're going to have a tablespoon of the dark tea.
So you don't need the bags?
No.
Not at all.
Loose tea releases
Okay.
much more flavor. Think of it like sliced deli meats. The thinner it is, the more flavor it is because there's more surface area.
Okay.
So we call them sachets. Tea in sachets is usually chopped up in a lesser quality. That's why they hide it in a bag. And to this Ceylon, we're going to add just a teaspoon of chai spice. Chai spice has cardamom, ginger, black pepper, lots of wonderful flavors. And we're going to basically cook this tea for about 3 minutes to release all the flavors. And traditionally, we're going to add a third cup of half and half. We've got 20 ounces of water in there. And in 3 minutes, you have a full pot of tea, a chai tea. Just strain that into a pot.
We got a
And
over here.
Serve it
Oh,
away.
this is
Try it
great,
from me and
great.
Maria.
Go ahead, you
Yes,
taste it.
I'll taste it.
Okay, chai tea here. What do you think?
Oh, it's very tasty.
Oh, good.
Surprisingly sweet too.
Chai by tradition is actually made with a very strong black tea with a touch of sugar and also the spice. Now, this compared to your French roast coffee, what do you think?
I think it's delicious.
Yeah, I like it. I would just worry about the headache I would get later if I don't get enough caffeine, but you're saying this could help. This could help me in the end.
Absolutely,
All right.
absolutely.
Sounds good. Well, to learn more about teas offered at Zhen Sha Tea Salon, visit our website, myfox28columbus.com, and just click under News Links.